Everyone,
it's the Sagan from Sign to Say, and welcome to a unexpected episode of Sign to Say, What's in the Box? I say it's unexpected because up until literally yesterday, I actually didn't know this was a thing until the Edison told me about it, and as soon as I found out what it was, I jumped on ordering it, and I was lucky to get one. Surely you know what it is since you clicked on the video, but it is the Zelda Game & Watch for the 35th anniversary of Zelda. I was not expecting this to be a thing, did not know this was going to be a thing, and yet here we are. So for those that don't know, it is a old-fashioned Nintendo Game & Watch, but it is loaded with Legend of Zelda, Legend of Zelda 2, Link's Adventure, and Legend of Zelda, Link's Awakening, the original Game Boy edition, I believe. Might be the DX version, but I don't know. We'll find out. Because it is a color screen, so it could very well be the DX edition, which basically just has a colored dungeon. But, yeah, I really wanted this because, I mean, I'm a huge Zelda fan, and it was a cool, fun little thing I can carry around, play with, and it's also meant as a display piece. And that's something I'm very fond of, because I have a big display case here in my office. Although this one may not go in my office. It actually may go in one I'm planning on putting downstairs. So, we'll see. But let's go ahead and unbox it. So, I have not opened this. I have no idea what to expect in here other than the unit itself. I haven't read anything about it other than its official description on Nintendo. That was enough for me to go, yep, I want it. And so, everything else is going to be a surprise. So, let's find out what's in the box. Well, damn it, wouldn't you know, I slit the plastic on this end thinking I was going to slide, but this is actually a plastic sleeve I need to slide out, and it's taped on the other side, so I'll be right back while I get the scissors. Okay, now that I've slid that out, this comes right out. Oh, that's funny. The screen graphic is actually part of the cover. So let's see here. Wow, okay, so that's probably much closer to what, like, an original Game & Watch box looks like. I actually don't know. But I know that they've actually included an old Game & Watch game, but have edited one of the sprites instead of being Mr. Game & Watch to being Link, which I think is awesome. Anyway, let's open this up, find out what's inside. Oh, before I open it, I should cover what it says is included on the back. So it has, as I mentioned, Legend of Zelda, and then Zelda 2, The Adventure of Link, Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening, and then it has the Game & Watch game Vermin, but done, like I said, as with Link instead of Mr. Game & Watch, and then Playtime Clock. So yeah, this is meant as a display piece, and you can have it just display a clock, which I think is great. And it looks like they have two different versions. You can either do Legend of Zelda or Zelda 2. So that's really cool. All right, let's take a look at it. Okay, so here's what's in the box. We have a nice nice holding thing with the Triforce on it. Obviously, instruction manual, which I will go through later because I don't mind reading instructions. But I probably will need to charge this before I can use it. We'll find out. If that's the case, I'll be stopping the video now and interesting. Okay, I have to potentially keep this thing always charged or I may lose my save data. Not guaranteed, but potential for it to happen. That's, I suppose, understandable. Anyway, I don't need to bore y'all with that. There also is a My Nintendo sticker, but I'm not going to show that on screen because it has a code. Just make sure that I am got you guys in frame. My screen has a tendency to turn off while I'm filming, which is kind of annoying. Alright, so here we are. Let me go ahead and pull this out. Oh, good. Okay, so this is the display case for it as well. That's cool. I kind of wish it wasn't made out of cardboard. I wish they'd done like a, you know, plastic, but that's still nice. I definitely will make use of that. All right, here we are. That is the unit itself, the Legend of Zelda Game & Watch That is, I mean, as far as I've seen Game & Watches, that pretty much looks like the real damn thing, except obviously the screen is going to be a full-color screen instead of a, you know, LCD display that, you know, has predetermined graphics. Yeah, that is nice. And we got a Triforce stamped in the back and all the usual legal info. Okay, let's go ahead and turn her on and see how this looks. Power button is over here on the side. Okay. Well, I'm already happy. Okay, so that is a very nice color screen for this. I didn't know what to expect, to be honest. It's looking a little washed out on the camera, but that may just be the display on the camera. It's hard to tell. Trust me, it is a very vibrant, full-color image right there. All right, I'm going to press the time button, which I assume is to set the time. Oh, got a Triforce. It's dangerous to go alone, take this. Should I be setting the time now? What, it's kind of... Looks like it's just in a demo mode of Zelda 1. Let me hit time again here. No? Anything? Okay, let me consult the instructions. Well, shit ye not, comrades, the instructions do not actually tell me anything. okay, so I hit this pause set button. And it looks like I can set the time that way. So it is currently 11:06 p.m. Really? Were we in military time here? Okay, 11:06 p.m. set. I wonder why it's making this beeping noise. Interesting. I only have a choice of off or 3 minutes for auto sleep. I guess I'll leave it off for now. Okay, I'm going to turn this off and turn it back on, because I don't like that it's making this noise. Maybe that's just what it does in the demo mode. Okay, well, with that in mind, then, we will, set this to timer? I don't want a timer. How do I just get to the clock? Although that is, like, really cool. Oh, that's... That's neato. Cool, well that's if I need a stopwatch or something. Oh, wait a minute, I can actually control Link here. I didn't expect that. I figured this was all automated. Been a while since I played Zelda 2. Something I should give a fair shake, I imagine. Reset timer, yes. Now. Alright, let's do the obvious here. Oh, that's cool. I can play both in English and Japanese. Oh, man. Okay, better not get that copyright strike. Register my name. As always. Sigan. I mean, that is straight up Legend of Zelda, ladies and gentlemen. It's dangerous to go alone, take this. Alright, well that is Zelda, ladies and gentlemen. But Let's check the thing I really wanted. Oh yes. Didn't have you guys in front, I'm sorry. Oh, man. For those that don't know, I have the original Brick Game Boy. That was my Game Boy, and this was my pack-in title. So this one is very near and dear to me. As a display piece handheld for it was enough for me to buy it anyway. Having the Nintendo, or having the NES titles is just icing on the cake. It's this one, and this is straight up, this is Link's Awakening, as is. No DX version, that's fine, I don't need the extra dungeon. It would be neat, they could have done the color version, but I think they wanted to go for the classic here, and yeah, this is awesome. Okay, so if I hit, okay, that lets me, let's go and try the vermin real quick. Okay, pretty simple Game & Watch, just got a bonk. That looks really crisp too, like they've done a good job at replicating the old LCD style graphic on a, you know, on a actual just LCD screen. Oh, these are going to get faster, aren't they? Fuck. What, do I lose already? Oh, no, I'm still going. Oh, I see, I have lives. Okay. Probably have, like, 3 fails and game over. Shit. Shoot her! Come on. I think that's game over. Yep. Okay, that's neat. Alright, so then if I just want the time, don't know why it makes that tick noise. I assume there's a way to turn that off, probably just by turning the volume down. Yeah. Okay. I guess it's probably ticking off the seconds, which I just realized we're also ticking around the edge of the screen, which is kind of cool. So it should be 11:14, right about... now. Nice. Cool. Alright, well, I'm going to put this in its little display case. Give me one moment. Oh, actually, before I do that, one more thing. I haven't looked at this yet. Edison told me to turn this on, turn around, and look at the back of it. And he did not elaborate. And I did not look it up because I wanted to know. So let's see if there's anything noteworthy on the back. Okay. That's pretty cool. The Triforce lights up. That's nice. Okay, let me get it in its display case. All right, ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. The Zelda Game & Watch. And I can just put that in as a display piece in my display cabinet and leave it on. You know, I'll have to take it out and charge it up every now and then, but leave it on as a clock. And I think that's pretty awesome. So thank you all so much for joining me on this somewhat impromptu episode of Science to Say, What's in the Box? I hope you all enjoyed, and until next time, you stay classy, Internet. We're science. Elastic tubes and bots and bins.